Is that where that little girl was from?
Yeah.
I mean, I guess I really shouldn't call her a little girl, considering her condition, but she seems so young.
She is very young.
Well, that's so sad to me. You know, babies having babies. I mean, pregnancy should be something that's joyous and wonderful. Mm-hmm. And instead, two teenagers get carried away, and the next thing you know, a little girl misses out on the rest of her childhood. I'm just assuming that was the scenario.
Well, it's not really anything I can get into, but in this case, nobody really knows what happened. Tina doesn't remember.
She doesn't remember getting pregnant? Is that possible?
Sorry. I've already said too much.
Oh no, it's confidential, of course. If she doesn't remember, then it must have been something really traumatic that way. That's why she's protecting herself from the memory?
Yeah, I suppose that's right. But if that is true, I just hope it doesn't come back to haunt her. They say repressed memories usually do that, one way or another.
Keisha, the girl that was with you, was that Tina?
Yeah.
Does she have a good doctor?
Yeah, she does. Why, did you want to recommend someone?
No, actually, just the opposite. See, I have this friend who's pregnant, and she needs a good OB. I was wondering, could you give me his name?
Sexism rides again. It's a she. Her name is Dr. Newman. In fact, she's right here in this hospital.
Dr. Newman, yeah, that does sound familiar. Does she also have a good psychiatrist?
Carly, like I was saying, I really can't get into her private, personal...
Oh, gosh, no, I'm sorry. I keep asking you the wrong questions. It's just that I was thinking about what you said before about repressed memories always coming back. Did you hear that from a professional person?
I don't know. No, actually, I think I heard it in Psych 101. I know there's one theory that states that people have to dig up old memories before they can get rid of them.
Well, maybe Tina won't have to do that.
Yeah, I hope not. And you know, maybe once the baby's put up for adoption, she can go back to school and grow up a little, you know, move on with her life.
But she's not thinking about keeping the baby?
Oh, no. No, she's having a really hard time. But Carly, the girl's 15 years old, and she doesn't even know who or
no,
how.
I know. You're right. Well, I hope she does what you say. But I hope she meets somebody, you know, and maybe she could fall in love. I'm really big on that power of love thing.
Wow. Love can't do everything.
I don't know about that. You know, I think if you've got enough love in your heart, then there's not enough room for any of that bad stuff to get in, and it just kind of goes away.
I'd like to believe that one. Oh, hey. You all set? Good. Will you do me a favor? Mm-hmm. Will you go tell the boys we're going to go?
Sure.
Okay. I'll see you outside.
You know, Keisha, AJ's doing really well these days.
Really? Well, I'm glad to hear that, Carly. Yeah, I saw the two of you come in together at the nurse's ball.
He gave me a ride. He is my neighbor, you know? He lives down the hall from me and Tony.
Oh, well, that's nice. I'm glad he's got friends close by.
Yeah, me and Tony we think he's the greatest, you know? It's really beautiful to watch how hard he is working to quit drinking. Keisha, look, I know that this is none of my business, but I just imagine the two of you must have made the best couple, and now that he's not drinking anymore, who knows?
Carly, I gotta go. It was good seeing you.
You too.
Take it easy.
Okay. Oh, that was my last patient. What a long day it's been.
Probably want to cut back on your schedule, make things a little easier on yourself.
Well, no, I'm nowhere near that yet. But who knows? You know, I might feel so terrific that I could work all the way up until the last minute. It was really a wonderful surprise seeing Keisha today, wasn't it? She looked great.
Yeah, she does.
Then again, she always does. I like her. So much, you know, she's always very straightforward, very honest. I can see why you fell in love with her.
So what time's your first session tomorrow?
8:30, I think. Yeah, and it's gonna be mostly with the parallel bars.
All right, then I'll make sure they're free.
Okay. Thanks. I guess I'll pick my stuff up then.
Whoa, what are you doing? Give me.
AJ, what?
I may not know much about being pregnant, but I'm pretty sure you're not supposed to overexert yourself.
Pregnancy's not an illness, okay? We're gonna drive each other nuts if you treat me like I'm sick all the time. I'm very healthy, and I'm very strong, and I'm not gonna do anything that's dangerous.
All right, I'll try not to be overly protective.
And please remember not to say anything about a little secret, because if Bobby finds out...
I know how to keep a secret. Did I tell anyone about Jake's?
I certainly hope not.
I didn't. And that was a very important night for me.
How do you mean?
That was the last night I had a drink?
Of course. Yeah.
Right. I just wish it wasn't such a blank, you know? But I guess little by little, I'll remember everything that happened that night.
Which night is that?
Yeah, I was just telling Carly about a blackout I had when I was drinking. Bits and pieces keep floating to the surface, so I guess I'll just remember it one day.
Well, some things are better off forgotten.
You have a point, but I don't seem to have much control over it.
Your subconscious has its own agenda, then.
Tony, isn't that a patient of yours? The one that you said was such a hoot because he always told you dirty jokes right up until he went under?
Mr. Hoover, I gotta say hello. Excuse me.
Relax. I know you don't want me to tell Tony that night we got pooped together, okay? Listen, I think keeping these secrets are stressing you out.
I will be okay.
But I do appreciate it.
What, did he tell you another joke?
Well, you want to hear the one about a traveling astronaut?
Bring it on.
No, spare me.
This woman is no fun at all. So I understand you're going to have your hands full pretty soon.
Oh, you mean with all the new members? Yeah, it should be interesting.
What's that?
Well, the GH gym is going to be open to the public now, for a fee, of course. That's the way they defray costs here at the hospital. But I think it's going to add a lot of responsibility to you, right? You okay with that?
Yeah, I think so. I think so. If I just keep my life simple and stay focused on the program, I should be able to handle it. I don't know. I better go adjust the speed on the treadmill for Mr. Hoover. It looks like he's losing the race.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you know, Tony... Do you think there's such a thing as keeping your life too simple?
Well, AJ seems to be doing pretty well.
He is, yeah. But, you know, he has so much free time after work with nothing to do except think about things he really shouldn't be thinking about too much.
And what sort of plans are you making for his free time?
No plans. I just think AJ's a really great guy. I...